Hey guys, this is Mark. Backendless console has been updated to simplify the internal navigation between various parts of console, and I wanted to give you an overview of the changes that you are seeing in it. First of all, previously we had the frontend and backend sections where the frontend had everything related to the user interfaces and visualizations, and backend had everything related to the backend. We got rid of those two sections and merged the most important functional areas in this left-hand navigation menu. And as you can see now, there is a block called backend, and there is one called frontend, and they have different background colors just to distinguish them visually. Whenever you navigate to any one of these sections, the current one will have this border and will highlight that this is the backend and we're looking at the database here. Or if we were to go to UI Builder now, all you do is you click on the UI Builder icon and then the frontend section becomes the active one. The manage icon does not belong to neither frontend nor backend because it has the general configuration settings that apply to the entire application. And by doing so, it saves at least one click, where previously if you were in UI Builder and you had to go to the database, you would need to click backend and then go to the database. Now you can just click on data and you will be in the database. So that's while it is only one click, I believe it is a fairly important simplification in terms of the performance you get just to navigate between different parts of Backendless console. Marketplace is also right here, so everything else, it should be familiar to you. To create a new application, the new app button is now available in this dropdown. So if you click to see the list of your apps, you will see this create new app link, and that's how you go to the pop-up to create a new application. This video I'm recording in our staging cluster because these changes were not pushed to the production yet, but whenever it is in production, you'll be able to switch between the European and North American cluster just by clicking right here, and you will get the drop-down to select between the clusters. And whatever the cluster is selected, the list of applications will show the apps from the currently selected cluster. These three dots are legacy services. So these are various parts of the UI that we will be deprecating soon just because they are either being merged into other sections of console or just simply being deprecated. So that's the main navigation that you are going to be seeing, or that you actually see now, because by the time this video is out, all the changes are going to be available in production. Something else that I wanted to bring your attention. So missions button stays as it is right now. And if you are going through Backendless missions, that's exactly how you're going to get there, just by clicking the missions button. Something else that is fairly important, in the upper right corner, you will see these icons right here. And there are tooltips to indicate what they are. So the first one is the navigation assistant, so Backendless Navigator. And then when you click Backendless Navigator, you get this pop-up where you can literally type in anything that you need to find. So for instance, if you're looking for something related to database relations, then you will see a suggestion for various videos or documentation or parts of the console that have anything to do with whatever you're querying. So if, let's say, we're looking for security role and you want to add a security role, just click on this and it will take you to the interface where you can actually create a new security role. And then that part of the interface is actually in the backend users, and as you can see, security roles. So more than likely, you will know how to navigate a certain part of the interface, but using Navigator may make it simpler if you're not fully familiar with where things are, or you just need to find a video or part of the documentation. Next one is the support forum. So if you click on that, it is a shortcut to our support forum. Then this is the Slack channel. If you're not part of it and you click, then you will be you will see the screen where you can join our Slack channel. then this UI suggestions. This is a simplification that we introduced. Previously, every single screen in Backendless console had its own section for comments. Like if you were in the app settings or security or really any part of the interface, it had its own icon to submit comments. And now, no matter what screen you are on, this UI suggestions icon will be linked to the current screen. So if you click on it, then it opens up the comments for, as you can see, the data table browser, which is the current screen. Now, this UI suggestions, it is not a way to get support. So if you are if you need help with support in terms of figuring out how to do something, how certain APIs work, or how things work in console in general, do not use this UI suggestions. This is really is intended as a way for you to provide feedback to us for how things should be improved, or if you have any ideas for various improvements or features and so on, please enter them in the UI suggestions. And finally, this icon right here that says I, it provides a bunch of other resources that you may find useful, such as a link to the documentation, our Telegram chat, the release history of the entire Backendless platform. You can download project templates or download the collection of our APIs for Postman. So all of these are under this I information icon. Finally, the avatar icon right here. If you were to click on my account, this is also a very important section where you will see a bunch of other things, such as your account information and your community profile, everything related to billing, then marketplace submissions, so you can submit your products to marketplace, referrals, where you can actually get referrals by referring your friends, co-workers to Backendless, and managing comments or deleting your account. So all of this is going to be behind this My Account icon. Clicking on the Home icon currently will take you to the same as the Manage, and that may change in the future because we're working on some things that will make this Home icon more meaningful. This concludes the overview of the changes that you are seeing now, and I do hope that you find these changes useful, and they make a lot of sense, and I think they provide a way to navigate between different parts of the console in a lot more streamlined. Thank you for watching this video, and as always, happy coding with Backendless.